Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be discussing about M2M and IoT network. To be more precise, here in this video, I'll be discussing more about what is M2M network. So let us start this session with first agenda, that is, what is the meaning of IoT and M2M network. To understand that, first I'll be discussing about in general idea of what is IoT and M2M network. See, both provides remote access in between devices. So IoT and M2M both provides access to the information without human intervention. So here devices will be sharing information in between each other in both of the cases, IoT as well as M2M. So first what I'll do is I'll explain you what is the basic meaning which is there with M2M network. See, when it comes to M2M network, then it provides direct communication in between individual machines or devices. It is designed to communicate between devices for a specific purpose. So here purpose is specific in case of M2M. Here network will be limited, right? And application will be specific. You can say it is therefore proprietary work, right? While when we talk about IoT, at the time we are generalizing our application. Let me define IoT over here. So as if I talk about what is IoT, then here IoT is a broader concept for internet communication between devices. Here M2M, that is not a broader concept. Here limited devices will be communicating with each other, but in IoT we are having broader concept for internet communication in between devices. It involves a wide range of devices, sensors, actuators and applications that communicates with the use of internet, right? So here in IoT we are having broader network. Here we will be using internet for a communication with many applications. While with M2M, although devices are communicating with each other, right, but purpose is specific. See, in M2M also we are using internet. It is not like in M2M we are not using internet, but purpose is specific, network is limited. While in case of IoT, purpose is broad, where varieties of devices, varieties of sensors, actuators, applications, those are communicating with the use of internet, right? So M2M uses non-IP based proprietary network, right? Here, although at last you can have IP based communication, but that is used for proprietary network. While in case of IoT, we are using broad networks, protocols based on IP, right? So that is how things are there with IoT and M2M. Now I'll be going to explain you architecture of M2M network. Now I'm going to explain you M2M architecture along with its basic blocks. So first of all, you need to understand how M2M area network is there. See, in M2M area network, there will be machines. So here one M2M area network is there, in which these machines are interconnected with each other with varieties of protocols. Here second M2M area network is there, where these machines are interconnected with each other. Now basic interaction in between machine is possible over here with the use of communication protocols. Like in this area network, these machines can interact with each other with the use of some basic protocols like Bluetooth, ZigBee, Wi-Fi, NFC. These are the protocols that we use it for communication over here in between these machines, right? But this M2M area network's device and this M2M area network devices cannot communication with each other over here directly. To have that communication, we need to have M2M gateway. So M2M gateway, that is acting like the intermediary node, where by having this M2M gateway, there will be translation of protocols data. See, here for example, we are having communication as per Bluetooth, and as if here there is a communication as per Wi-Fi, then direct communication over here is not possible. So here this M2M gateway, that will be acting like the translator, right? After M2M gateway, there will be M2M core network. See, this M2M gateway, that will be translating data given by this device and it will be giving it to M2M core network. This M2M core network, that could be wireless or it could be wired, right? Here, after M2M core network, at last, there will be M2M application. See, in M2M application, there will be all the categories of tasks like maintenance, upgradation, as well as service, right? Like here at MTM applications page, here there will be client application where client can provide varieties of services to all these devices, right? And here, see, in this given M2M network, these devices can communicate with each other, but as if these devices are interested for a communication with another M2M network, then M2M gateway that will come into the picture. And handling of all the application that will happen over here at client application side, right? So that is how basic architecture is there. Now I'm going to explain you what is M2M gateway and what is the basic need of M2M gateway. See, M2M gateway that is act as a intermediary between various devices and systems in machine to machine setup. So I have told you we are having M2M area network, right? So within that M2M area network, devices can communicate with each other. But if one M2M area network wants to communicate with another M2M area network, in that case, you need to have intermediary node that will be M2M gateway. See, it provides following functionalities. You should know these functionalities. See, it provides communication in between machines. For that, it provides connectivity. It also provides data exchange between machines, and it also provides compatibilities between different networks. The reason is it is highly possible that one M2M network will be having one protocol, second M2M network will be having another protocol. So here, compatibilities that has to be given in between different network. Now I'm going to explain you what is the basic purpose of M2M gateway, right? So to understand that, see, here you need to understand one thing. Within the network, nodes can communicate with each other, but to communicate with remote M2M area network, M2M gateway that is highly required, right? So basically, when it comes to M2M gateway, then you should know from one M2M area network to second M2M area network, there has to have translation. So there can be connectivity issues, there can be data exchange issues, there can be compatibility issues, right? So all those issues are getting resolved at the side of M2M gateway. Now I'll be going to explain you M2M gateway structure. As I have explained, M2M gateway is used for a communication in between two different M2M area network. But how? For that, you need to understand basic architecture. Like as I have told you, in M2M area network, there can be different protocols. Like we can have Bluetooth, ZigBee, MBUS, MWB, Modbus, Z-Wave. Likewise, there can be varieties of protocols, right, in M2M area network. And in given area, all the nodes can communicate. But as if we have different M2M area network, like as if one node wants to communicate with another node, and if another node is having different protocol, then M2M gateway that will come into the picture. So here M2M gateway that will be acting like the intermediary node. You can observe here, see, you can say it is virtual node where it will be acting like a proxy node where it does protocol translation. So as if here one node is having Bluetooth protocol and second node is having protocol based on UWB, then at M2M gateway using proxy node, we will be doing protocol translation, right? Once that protocol translation is done, then via IP routing, here we will be providing that to M2M wide area network, right? And after that, it will go to application, and from application, again, commands can be given, right? So from client application, again, commands can be released, and those commands that will be coming over here as per IP routing, and that could be given to another node, which is there with different network, right? So let us summarize what is M2M network. See, when it comes to M2M network, then it is a fundamental concept of IoT. See, this is fundamental concept, right? IoT is a broader concept where many applications are integrated together with the use of internet, while in case of M2M, purpose is specific. Here we are talking about limited application, right? While IoT is a broader concept. In IoT, there will be so many networks, there will be so many devices, there will be so many sensors, actuators, so many data will be there in IoT, while in M2M, we are having specific application. So M2M, that is a fundamental component of IoT, right? You can say IoT is a broader concept for device communication, right? So M2M is the backbone of IoT application, right? So as if you understand how M2M network is getting formed, and as if multiple M2M applications are getting combined together, then you can say it will be going to form IoT network, right? I hope this video is beneficial to you. And as if any query is there, just post that in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.